Well, hello there, YouTube. Chilling with Twisted420 here once again. And I'm probably going to get hit with copyright infringement on this video. So let's go ahead and get it out of the way and rock out a little bit. Get into my car. Okay, people, in all seriousness though, I'm here to show you guys the Atari speaker hat. Okay, the Atari speaker hat. You heard that right. And this is the Blade Runner 2049 limited edition variant. Okay, when I saw this thing, I was like, I want to make a video on it. Okay, but for two, I would like to have a speaker hat. I didn't know of any speaker hats before this. This is the first speaker hat I've ever known of, so I had to get it. And plus, I like bike riding and stuff, so I figured this might be a pretty cool solution other than having headphones on, just freaking speaker hat. And I gotta say, the audio experience is weird. The audio kind of wraps around your face. It's different. And it gets louder if you turn the cap backwards. Obviously, your ears are back there, the speaker's back there. But anyway, they got a sale going on right now on all their speaker hats for $99, $100 basically, right? When I bought mine, it was like $130, $140. No big deal. They're doing a sale right now, and that's pretty pricey. It's pretty pricey, but do you know of any other speaker hats? I don't know of any other speaker hats. Okay, now what we're gonna do is a few different tests. We're gonna play a few different variations of music, a few different genres, let you see what that sounds like. We'll do a distance test where I walk away and all that good stuff. But first, I want to talk about the packaging. I gotta say, the packaging is quite nice on this guy. Atari did a really good job, or shall I say Atari Life. The packaging is really nice. You open it up, you get your hat inside there, that's good. And you also get some manuals, a micro USB charging cable, and a Blade Runner 2049 sticker in there. Now, the reason I went with the Blade Runner 2049, for one, it was limited edition. I like limited edition stuff, and I love the colorway, that kind of sky blue. I dig it. Now, the way this guy works is you got a little button on the side. You hold that button down to turn it on. You get a blue light that blinks. And pairing it up with your phone is as simple as any other Bluetooth device. You hook it up, it's good to go. Underneath the bill, you're going to notice you got two speakers with some kind of little interesting grill cloth over them. And the way they're made, this hat, you can't really, it's going to stay in kind of the curved duck bill position. You're not going to be able to flatten this out, do anything, because those speakers are there. But inside the hat, on one side, you have your battery pack, right? And it's just chilling. And the problem is, they don't tell you what size battery it is. Nowhere on the website, in the manuals, nobody lets you know what size battery is in it. But on battery life, I did test it, and you get about 2.5 hours of battery life per charge. So not bad, not bad. It's probably like a 600 mAh, 1,000 mAh, I don't know, it's hard to say. On the opposite side, you're gonna have your charge port and your 2.5 millimeter headphone jack. Okay, it's a standard micro USB charge port, easy peasy. Now, you would think with the battery pack and the module on here, it would make it weird, but I gotta say, they still found a way to make it comfortable. The weight of the packs is up here on the top of your side of your head, and you don't really feel it. So kudos on that. I think they did a pretty good job there. But other than that, that's it. You got your two modules, you got a button, and you got speakers. That's it. Okay? Now, as far as audio quality isn't just fantastic, and you could probably assume that if it's built into the brim of a hat. They get a little bit tinny at the highest range, but I gotta say, overall, they're not that bad. These are about 2-inch speakers that they got on here, and they're really not that bad, especially when you're on your head and you're riding around. Now, if you have this thing turned up all the way, everybody's gonna hear it. It's loud, okay? Right now, let's go ahead and do a couple of tests. We're gonna play a few different genres of music, and then we're gonna do a distance test. That sound good? Okay, people, we're gonna start with hip hop, and I'm gonna start at about half volume and raise it up. Not very loud at half volume. Bumping it up now. Okay, people, next we're gonna try a little bit of metal. Raise it up. Not bad. Okay, people, here's a little bit of electronic music, half volume once again. Not Also want to mention, it depends on what audio source you play from. Like most of those that I just did the test on, that was all on YouTube. Now on Pandora, and even in the car, I noticed a difference between YouTube and Pandora. On Pandora, it's a little bit louder. Money Trees on Pandora is noticeably louder than anything else I just played. Can't fast forward either, it's a long ass intro. But you get what I'm saying, you guys get the thing. It's pretty damn loud on Pandora, so audio sources do make a difference. Now that we've done a little bit of testing, what we're gonna do for our final test is a little bit of a distance test, and then we'll give our final conclusion, all right? Okay, people, I got some random, Post Malone pulled up on Pandora. I'm just gonna walk backwards and walk forward with the volume at full blast and kind of see what it sounds like. Shut up, Alexa. We are using a boom mic, Rode VideoMic Pro, to record the audio. Should be good to go. Let's see what we got. This is maybe 15 feet, 20 feet, I don't know. Okay. Okay, now I'm gonna put the hat on backwards, put it on a different song, and try it again. Let's see what happens. I don't know. All right. I don't know how this is gonna sound until I edit it, but I gotta say, turn backwards, much louder. But yeah, that's just a quick distance test. And there you have it, people. Just messing around. I wanted to show you guys something I thought was a pretty quirky little product. Now, 150 bucks is a bit pricey, but I gotta say, if you like what you see and you got the disposable income, why not grab it? I think it's pretty cool. There's nothing else like it. So yeah, kudos to Atari Life for doing something different. I think it's pretty neato. But I'll have links in the description if you want to go check it out. And other than that, people, that's what I got for you. Y'all stay sexy out there.